Hey guys. So today in my sketchbook, I am playing with color and architecture. I don't really do a whole lot of places and buildings. It's also kind of weird to pick up a ruler and make straight edges because, you know, even when I'm doing buildings and places, I have a tendency to just wing it and, you know, it's all about the organic lines, but today it's all about the straight lines. So a little bit of information about this building. I spent some time in Google Street View, kind of touring around the neighboring cities, just looking for something that I could use as a photo reference. That's why I'm really excited about spring and summer coming, because I'd really like to go out and take my own reference photos, because I don't have any, because I never leave the house. But anyway. So this building is Hotel Europe. It is located in Gastown section of Vancouver. It was built, I think it was 1901? And it was designed to fit in this really strange looking lot. It's a triangular lot, very long triangle. So it comes to this really dramatic point, and they call that a flat iron building because it's shaped like a flat iron. And let's see. And it seems to be one of the buildings that they take care of, and I think it's renovated for low income housing at the moment. So it is in use and it is in good shape. And that's fantastic. And so, when painting an oddly shaped building, I did choose this angle for a bit of simplicity, I guess. You don't really quite see the drama in the shape, except for maybe in the tight little curve around where the windows are. It's definitely wild to look at in real life. So I started by laying down some guidelines. The horizontal lines were kind of tricky, and I don't think I quite got them in the right spot because the perspective point is gone off the paper. I can't really draw from it, so I'm just kind of guessing a little bit. And honestly, I could have gone way more extreme than this. I think perspective wise I didn't get it. But on its own, in my sketchbook, no one would notice the difference. So I'm just gonna leave it. And I'm gonna add a bunch of windows. And honestly, I was really nervous about putting the color down because I didn't really know what I was doing. I didn't know what I was doing. I know that that light was coming from a specific angle, and that white, leaving things white where the brightest of light is, was gonna be a good idea. I know that yellow is the warmest color, so things that I want to have in the front should be more yellow than everything else. I ended up doing the whole thing yellow first, and then adding more colors in a warm to cool pattern. So I know that the left side of this building is in shadow, so I started adding cooler reds, and then eventually violets and purples. I did all of my shadows in purple. In fact, I'm using this Peerless set of watercolors. It comes in a book, and I thought that this would actually be a good use for them, because Peerless is kind of difficult to manage. You can't really mix colors. It's not like a palette. You can't mix your colors on a palette. I suspect you're supposed to rip a piece off and stick it in a little puddle of water and then color the water. And then you can mix puddles together, but I usually like to work with watercolor dry. So knowing that I had absolutely no control over the vibrancy of the colors that I'm using, I thought that this sort of unrealistic color profile would be perfect for this kind of paint. Because it won't matter how bright the colors are when I put them down, because I'm not trying to get realistic ones. Yeah, these paints are really good for really dramatic color applications. And this is just on cardstock, like this isn't even watercolor paper. I put some plant life where there wasn't, and I added a little cat shadow in one of the windows in the back. It was sort of suggested in the stream chat. And when I felt like I was done, I re-added back in the pencil lines because I really liked having them there. I thought it was really cool to have that little extra sketchy detail. So overall, I really enjoyed this piece, and I can't wait to make new ones, and I can't wait for spring to come so I can go out building, hunting, you know, looking for cool details, things to take pictures of and to paint. It's a really exciting time of the year for me. Just like endless possibilities, you know? Anyway, so I think I might turn this page into a journal cover, and that should be available as soon as possible. And I really enjoyed this one, and I hope you enjoy this video as well. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!